Alright, what up you guys? Just pulled up to Woods Valley, about to go get my clubs out of the car. All you have to do is say the secret password, Shannon and a bang bang, and it opens just like, alright, get my clubs out of the trunk, onto the cart, put this in there, tighten that up, this, shoes off, shoes on, Tatum advisor, open door, get TaylorMade backpack. Now my TaylorMade backpack, okay, it's like Mary Poppins bag. Whatever you want, it just keeps coming out of here, okay?
I always say the place to hang a hat is on a hat stand.
Put that on there. Get this key right in there. Large bucket. There you go. All right, pulling up to the back of the range is about right. So this video is probably be called Gabe's Golf Course POV or something like that. If you don't know what POV stands for, it stands for point of view. As you can see, you guys are seeing everything from my point of view, my perspective. Balls check, glove check, and clubs checkeroni, macaroni. Okay, so anyways, pulling up here is the range. Yeah, stuff you already know. All right, what up you guys? So on the back of the range here, and I wanna show you a couple things that I am incorporating into my training regimen. Two simple things I haven't done before, and I'm gonna show you guys what they are. Okay, so open up my Mary Poppins backpack here. Anything you want in here.
I much prefer seeing all of my face at the same time.
Okay, so what I'm going to be carrying around with me is which I wanted to show you, is two main things. And one of them is a scorecard that I personally made. Nothing fancy, just made it on Microsoft Word here. Looks like this. And anyways, I'll just try to run through it with you. So this says hole, and you got 1 through 18 for obviously 18 holes of golf. And right here, this little square, I'm going to put the par. Club off the tee, did I hit left, straight, right? Distance in, whether it be 140, 100. Club in, did I hit pitching wedge, 8, 7. Distance to pin after I hit my club in, so maybe 40 feet away or something. Short game, putt distance, 30-foot putt, miss or make. And so yeah, just a little scorecard. I'm making notes on course, notes on round, how the course was playing, windy, was it dry, was it slow, was it playing harder than usual, notes on round, you know, just saying in case I can write down toed the majority of my shots, or I was having a problem hitting them heavy, or it was a good day overall. And you know, it's FIR, green art, GIR and putts, you know, fairies and red, greens and red. And
so yeah, that's just kind of a scorecard I'm going to be tinkering with, working with, you know. I know that the top players in the world, they take real detailed stats on their game, you know, bunker percentage, fairway percentage, greens, you know, which way are they missing them, what putts, you know, what's their putts made between 6 and 15 feet, which is, you know, the birdie range. And so yeah, I just want to try to get a more detailed area of my game so that I can look over these, you know, once I played, you know, maybe 10 rounds or so. And I can get more of a more specific design plan to approach my weaknesses. You know, I have a feeling this will really help me find where my weaknesses are, so that I can go from there and design a more efficient plan to improve my game. Okay, so another thing I wanted to show you guys is a journal. I'm gonna be starting a golf journal as well, so I'm gonna see how that goes. Never done that before.
And basically just got a regular Staples notebook here, little spiral book. And basically, what you want in this journal is, I didn't make this journal up, I found this, I heard of Olympic athletes using journals and for their training days, and this is what they had in it. So here you go. Things you want in this journal that I'm going to have are, so things you want in this journal is your date. You know, you put the date that you're there, what time is it, the duration of your practice. Location, training or competition, circle one of those, hours trained, what you accomplished that day, whether you could say, you know, I hit two large buckets,
I practiced short game for an hour, I putted for an hour, you know, what you accomplished, what did I do, you had 50 putts, you know, you went through your bag, hitting a jumbo bucket, kind of the same thing is accomplished, you know, I'm trying to figure it out myself. Also in this journal that you want to have, or which is probably one of the most important part, is solution analysis. What this is this, you write down if you came to any solutions during the day. So maybe you were slicing it and you started hitting it more straighter, or you started hitting back your draw. You write down what you did to correct that. Maybe you're hitting it heavy and you figured out you were staying on your right foot, your back foot too long. So all you had to do was get to your left side a little quicker, and that helped you not chunk it as much. So you just write down the solutions if you did come to any during your practice day. Another thing is success analysis. What you want to do is write down everything you did well during the day, whether if you had a good drive on a certain hole or your short game was extra good, whatever you did really well, write that down in your success analysis. And obviously at the end of the day, you're going to go over this, try to figure out where you can improve. And when you read that a success analysis, that's where, you know, you're going to try to recreate those same feelings of hitting those great shots. And the more you read and think about all the great things you've done, all the good things you did that day, you're giving it more likely that's going to happen again. So don't be thinking all your bad shots. Think about what you did good. Keep getting those over and over in your mind, and that's just going to make it more likely to happen next time. Also, what I have in here is goal statement. I was reading that it's really important to make goals during the days that you train, whether it be maybe you're doing chipping and you want to get 15 balls within 3 feet, or, you know, 15 balls within 5 feet from 20 yards away kind of thing. And you can't go home until you achieve those goals. You know, maybe you want to make 75 four-footers, or, you know, you want to hit a large bucket, but you want to be completely focused on each and every ball. So that's your goal statement if you have any goals before you start the day, which I think is crucial. So this is something I haven't done yet, but I'm going to tinker with it, let you guys know if I think this can really help your game out. You can try it out yourself, let me know how you like it. But yeah, put the date, time, location, you know, what you did, how long you did it for, did you come to any solutions, what success did you have during the day, what good shots did you hit, goal statement. And that way, once you get this journal, once you start using this detailed scorecard, I have a feeling that we're going to get a way better understanding of our games, where our weaknesses and what our strengths are. And, you know, you're going to get a good feel for how much you've practiced during the week. You might come to the realize, you know, I only practiced five hours this week, or I only practiced my putting 2 hours, you know. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to try to start doing. You guys can do it too. Let me know if you have any tips for me. I'm always looking to learn. So I'm probably going to hit some balls right now. I'm really weakening up my grip a lot. My grip was getting a little too strong, so swing feels really uncomfortable, but I'll record a couple swings for you guys, see how it looks.